Chris, every so often, a property report falls off the back of a truck. And I understand you have come across some information that's going to grab the attention of anyone interested in property.
That's right. Domain's house price report for the September quarter will be released this Thursday, Shelley. But we can exclusively reveal that Sydney and Melbourne will expect to see the biggest quarterly gains in 3 years. So there'll be stacks of detail, of course, on every capital city. And so you want to make sure you dive into it for that. But I wanted to know, is this the first quarter of a year in which we see Sydney and Melbourne shoot up by more than 10%, marking an instant return to the double-digit percentage price growth? So I put that question to Shane Oliver, one of Australia's best-known economists.
It's certainly possible, and that's a risk. I think after an initial bounce, things will slow down back into single-digit annual gains. But if you look at the recent gains that we've seen over the last few months, over the last quarter, they've really been pushing up there.
So I think this could be one of the big developing stories of the next couple of months. Prices rebounding more than the market had anticipated. So the gains seem to be flowing from rate cuts, and experts like Shane are predicting more of those to come. So the big question for everyone is, what do we do with that information? So I asked Shane Oliver that too.
I think there's a few things to consider. The first one is they're probably getting in at a lower price than they were paying a couple of years ago, so that's good. But also allow that eventually interest rates will start to go back up again. So make sure you use the opportunity provided by those very low rates to pay down your debt as quickly as you can.
Mm. So some good sense there, paying down your debt while you can. But of course, the full Domain property price report for the September quarter is out on Thursday. Definitely worth a look, I think, Shelley.
Absolutely. It'll be good reading. Yeah. To a new initiative now for more than 10,000 first home buyers. The federal government is providing a significant leg up for entry into the property market.
Yeah, this was a big story this week. The First Home Loan Deposit Scheme has passed through the federal parliament. It's a system where each year 10,000 first home buyers will be able to get a mortgage with only a 5% deposit. It's a guarantee system with the government acting as kind of the bank of mum and dad, really, guaranteeing the other 15%.
Well, to me that sounds like great news.
Yeah, well, I mean, you could certainly make that point. I mean, what it means for those people who would be getting it is you could get a $500,000 property with just $25,000 in savings. So this could be a game changer for those people, but it's only available to 10,000 people per year, which is about how many first-home buyers got loans last month alone. Oh. So it means that there's going to be far more applicants than lucky buyers. But
okay,
it is certainly nice to see the government pointing out what has been a really big issue in the property market, that deposit savings.
And the fact what we heard earlier about the property report, it seems like everything is shifting in directions people didn't quite know. So for the government to actually be helping out in any way is great, don't you think?
I think it's certainly interesting and important. And I think it's a pretty good time to see what bidders are going to be doing around the country. So
so you've got auction numbers for us?
Auction numbers. We've got the auction numbers. There's going to be 1,567 auctions around the country. Melbourne with 805 leading the way as usual. Sydney, pretty high number there at 605 this weekend, Shelley. Brisbane, 84. Adelaide, 50. And in Perth, 23, up from last week. Now, moving right along, it's quite interesting to see Perth bouncing back.